Hello learners, I am Radhika, course coordinator of Computer Science Senior Secondary subject. Today you will be learning about C++ programming language. It is a high level programming language. It was developed at AT&T Bell Laboratories by Bjarne Stroustrup. In this video, we will explain about C++ character sets, basic data types and tokens used in C++ programming language. Come, let us watch this video together.
Hello learners, I am Mohini Arora, I am HOD Computer Science and I will be taking the session for Introduction to C++ for Computer Science students. As you are very well aware, in this particular course, you will be learning the programming language C++. So this is the initial session. So let's begin the session. First and foremost, to learn any language, you know that C++ is a programming language. That means a language that is used to make a program. What is a program? A program is a set of instructions. So you have to learn the manner in which instructions should be given to the computer so that he can execute those instructions. Every language in this world has got certain set of characters. For example, English language has got the alphabets A to Z. Similarly, Hindi language has got its own varnamala. Similar manner, when I am learning a programming language, I need to know its character set. These are the set of valid characters that a language can recognize. Each character has got its own property, its own feature, its own usage. So a C++ character set consists of letters, which are alphabets from A to Z in capital and A to Z in small. We have digits 0 to 9. We have special characters that you see on the keyboard. Some of them are displayed on the screen, other are not displayed. But any character that you can type in on the keyboard is a special character. Other than special characters, we have white spaces. White spaces are those characters which cannot be seen on the monitor. For example, when you press a space bar, you can see the cursor moving, but nothing appears on the screen. Similarly, when you press a tab key, cursor moves by 8 spaces, but nothing is seen on the screen. So these are white space characters, tabs, blank spaces, new lines, all these are white space characters. After learning about character set, we need to know about data types. We have integer, floats, and character data types. These are the types in which data of different properties, features can be stored. Depending on the data that I want to store, I use that particular data type. Let's do these three basic data types. First one is integer, short form we call it int. An integer stores a whole number. Any number which is without a decimal point is an integer. Normally the range of an int data is between -32768 to 32767. And if we want to store numbers which are larger than these, which go out of the range specified, then we use long int. So whenever I want to use a whole number to be stored, I need to have an integer data type. Any number that you want to store which is without decimal point is an integer for C++. Next, we move on to float data type. It might be a situation that I want to store decimal numbers. If I want to store decimal numbers, then I have to use a float data type. Range of the float is 10 raised to power 38 to 10 raised to power minus 38. As you have seen in ints and floats also, that we can store both negative and positive numbers. If I want to store, I want to use a larger decimal point number with more precision, then we use a double data type. The examples of floats are shown on the screen. We move on to the next data type, which is the character data type. Short form is char. Integer and floats both were numeric data types. When I talk about numeric data types, that means I can do all sorts of arithmetic calculations on those data types. I can do addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and so on. But when I am talking about characters, I cannot do any arithmetic calculations on a character data type. These are non-numeric data types. It can consist of alphabets and numbers both, but the numbers that are used as characters, I cannot perform arithmetic calculations on them. The characters are included in single quotes, as you can see the examples. In this example, small a, 8. Now, 8 is a number, but when 8 is included in single quotes, it becomes a character. It is no longer an integer data type. 8 without the quotes is an integer data type. So that difference has to be very well understood by you people, that there is a difference between an 8 without quotes and an 8 with single quotes. An 8 without quotes is an int data type. An 8 with quotes is a character data type. So these are the three basic data types: integers, floats, and characters. We move on to the next topic, that is tokens. When I group characters to perform a particular job, or the characters that are logically belonging to each other to perform a particular job, then they form tokens. The types of tokens that are used in C++ are keywords, identifiers, literals, punctuators, and operators. We'll be covering all these one by one. First, we start with keywords. Keywords are the reserved words in C++ which have a predefined meaning. These words are already known to the compiler. They are known to have a particular meaning, and when these words are used, the compiler is expected to perform a particular job. For example, I'll give you a very simple example that we have done before. Int, a float, a char. An int signifies an integer. A float signifies a decimal number. A char signifies a character. So all these are keywords. I cannot use these keywords for any other purpose whatsoever. Next, we have identifiers. Identifiers are names used to identify data. Now, I am using a computer to store data. Data can be of any type. Say, suppose I am storing data of students of my class. I have to store the name, I have to store the age, I have to store marks, and so on. So, I have to differentiate this data by giving different names by which this data will be identified. So, identifiers are names used to identify data. For example, I identify, okay, this 18 years, the child is of 18 years, so age is 18 years. Now, these identifiers are formed from C++ character set only. Only those characters I can use which are acceptable by the C++ language. But yes, I have to use those characters to form identifiers so that data can be distinguished and identified. When I am using an identifier, when I am forming an identifier, certain rules have to be followed. Every identifier should consist of alphabets, digits, and only one special character is allowed, that is the underscore. Other than that, you cannot use any other special character. No spaces, no plus, minus, no hyphens, nothing. You can only use an underscore. Each and every identifier should always start with either an alphabet or an underscore. You cannot start an identifier with a digit. All identifiers are case sensitive. That means capital H, A-G-E, is not same as small h, A-G-E. Although the alphabets are similar, but they are not same. Why? Because the identifiers are case sensitive. Lowercase and uppercase are not considered same, they are different. And the last rule, an identifier cannot be a reserved word. It cannot be a keyword. We have just studied keywords. I told you that each keyword has got a specific meaning. You cannot use that keyword for some other purpose, because then the compiler will not understand what to follow. It will give you an error. We move on to the next topic, that is constants. As the name says, constants, the value which cannot be changed during the entire execution of the program is a constant. Any data type can be used to form a constant. I can form an integer constant, I can form a float constant, I can form a character constant. But once I form a constant, I declare a constant and I give it a value, I cannot change that value through the course of the program. If I try to change it, your compiler will flash an error. As the example says, a constant variable has to be preceded with the keyword const. So, I am giving the value 10 to the constant integer. So, now let's talk about variables. A variable is a location in computer memory that can store data. A name is given to this location so that the data that I am storing can be identified. Obviously, the name is given symbolically for easy reference, and every variable has to be declared first before it is used. If you try to use a variable without declaring it, the compiler will flash an error. In the examples that are given, in the first statement, I am declaring a variable marks, which is of integer type, and I am also giving it a value as 10. So, you can see that first I am giving the data type, which is int, then I am giving a space, then I am giving the name of the variable, which is marks, and then I am giving the value 10. In the second example, I am creating a variable grade, which is of character type. So, I am giving first the data type, which is char, then a space, then the name of the variable grade. Now, you have to be careful that while creating variable names, you have to follow the rules that you have done before while forming identifiers. Means each variable name can contain alphabets, digits, and an underscore. No space is allowed, no special characters allowed, and you cannot use a keyword as a variable name. Next, we move on to literals or constants. We have talked about constant a little while before, where I told you that a constant is a data item which cannot change its value during the execution of the program. If you try to change it, it flashes an error. And to create a constant, you have to precede the declaration of that constant with the keyword const. Different types of literals or constants that we are going to study are integer constants, character constants, floating constants, and string constants. You have heard about integers, characters, and floats in this session. String is something new. A string is a set of characters. Say, for example, I want to store your name. A character can store only a single character. Say your name is Amit. If I create a character variable, it will store only A. But a name is not a single character. A name is a set of characters. So, to store set of characters, I use strings. And if I want to give a fixed value to a string, it becomes a string constant. So, now let's do these various constants one by one. First, the integer constants. Integers are numbers, constants are fixed values. So, integer constants are whole numbers which are not having any fractional part, which are not having any decimals, and the values once given cannot be changed. Various types of integer constants are decimal, whose base is 10. The numbers, the decimal numbers are formed 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And decimal numbers should not begin with a zero. The examples are given on your screen. Then you have octal numbers or octal constants. The base is 8. Octal numbers consist of digits only 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And they are always starting with a zero. This is how you differentiate between a decimal number and an octal number. You can see that 0, 1, 3 is 13. If I write it just 1, 3, it is a decimal number. If I write 0, 1, 3, it becomes an octal number. Then you have the hexadecimal integers, which are of the base 16. These are consisting of digits 0 to 9. And then alphabets A to F. That means a 10 in decimal is A in hexadecimal. Similarly, an 11 in decimal is a B in hexadecimal, and so on. All hexadecimal numbers are preceded with either OX in small case or in uppercase. You can see in the examples OX4, OXE, OX51, all these are hexadecimal numbers. Next, we move on to character constants. Contains one or more characters, must be enclosed in single quotation marks. The examples are seen here. All characters, even the digit, as I explained before, it is a digit, but it is a character if it is enclosed in single quotes. And they can also have non-graphic characters or, as I explained before, white space characters which can't be typed directly from the keyboard, like backspace, tab, enter key. All these are white space or non-graphic characters. All these non-graphic characters are represented by escape sequences. The table here shows escape sequences for some of the character constants. If you want to use them in the program, say you want to use a backspace, you have to give slash B. You cannot press a backspace key in the program. It is not possible. But you want to show it in the output, the backspace key, the effect of the backspace key, then you will use a slash B. You want to show a carriage return, slash R. And so on. So, these are white space or non-graphic characters which are used in the program by using escape sequences. Next, we move on to floating constants. You know that floats are the decimal numbers. Each float number or a real number, or we call them real constants, have two parts, a fractional form and an exponential form. They can be positive, as integers can be positive or negative. Floats can also be positive, negative. The mantissa part, which is the integer constant, is followed by a capital E or a small e, while the exponent form is a integer. The examples are given below, like 2e03 or 3.45e07 means 03 is the exponent part, 2 is the mantissa part. Similarly, in the next thing, 3.45 is the mantissa part and 07 is the exponent part. So, these are floating constants. Next, we have string constants. A string is a set of multiple characters. A string is always and always enclosed in double quotes. If you remember, a character constant is enclosed in single quotes. A character constant is a single character. A string constant, on the other hand, is a set of multiple characters. So, it is always enclosed within double quotes. And every string constant is by default added with a null character at the end. The string is not terminated, means the end of the string is not considered till the time the null character is not encountered by the compiler. For example, let us consider the string as hello. Now, if you see, hello is formed from 5 characters, H-E-L-L-O. Together, they form a string hello. And in memory, hello is represented as shown in red. It is terminated by a null character. Every string, please remember, every string has to have a null character at the end. It is automatically added by the compiler when you save this string or when you enter the string through the keyboard. You will learn more about the strings in the coming sessions. Next, we move on to punctuators. Various special characters that you have on the keyboard are punctuators. Each and every character has got a specific purpose. you have to use it according to that very purpose. For example, round brackets cannot be used in place of curly brackets and vice versa, although they are brackets, but still they are used for specific purposes. Next, we have input-output. If I am making a program, I need to accept data from the user. I need to give the output to the user. So, I need to know how input and output can be done in a program. It is done using two streams, input and output streams. Cin is the console input stream. When I say console, it is the default input device, which is the keyboard. Cout is the console output stream. That means the default output device, which is the monitor. I use these two streams along with two operators, that is greater than and less than less than. We call them extraction operator or get from operator and insertion operator or put to operators respectively. So with Cin, I will use the symbol greater than, the first symbol that is coming on the screen. And with Cout, I use less than. So, whenever I want to input any data, I'll use Cin greater than. If I want to output any data, I'll use Cout less than. As you see in the example, I want to display the message hello. Hello is a string constant, if you remember. So, it is enclosed in double quotes. I want to display it on the monitor. I use it with Cout less than. I want to accept marks from the user. I declare the variable marks, because you remember we discussed before that a variable cannot be used without declaring it first. So, first I declared the variable marks and then I am asking the user to enter the value of marks. The command for the same is Cin greater than. So, whatever is coming from the keyboard is being stored in the variable marks, which is an integer type of variable. So, this is an example of input and output. So, this second statement, accepting an integer from the keyboard and storing it at the memory location by the name marks.
I hope you must have found this video very interesting. You have learnt about C++ character set, basic data types and tokens used in C++ programming language. In the next video, we will explain you the operators used in C++ programming language. Let us meet in the next video. Till then, it's bye from Radhika.